Okay, so now we're going to have a little bit of a conversation. Ahora vamos a conversar un poco con Dani Calanduyan y Titania Buchholz, who was playing the large gongs over here. Para los radioescuchas, los instrumentos básicos son como juegos de campanas. They're like a gong set. And there's a whole culture over a big swath of that part of the world with different kinds of music like this in Indonesia, formerly in Vietnam and all that. Pero esta música, but this musical tradition is unique to this part of the Philippine Islands. I say unique to there, digo que es una tradición única a esta parte de las Islas Filipinas, pero al mismo tiempo, ahora sí forma parte de la cultura de California. I say it's unique to the Philippine Islands, but it's also right now part of California culture. So thank you so much. Dani Calanduyan es una joya no solamente nacional sino internacional. Dani Calanduyan is a jewel. He's a gift to all of us, not only in the national level, not only in the state level, but also internationally as well. Así que estamos muy agradecidos. We're very appreciative of what you have done here to spread your culture and enrich all of our lives. So tell me a few things here. Maybe we can get a few things out here and later have a discussion with our public present here. I hear that women play a very prominent role in this music in the Philippine Islands. Is that correct?
That's right. The those small gongs is actually for women's instrument. It's considered a female instrument, but the rest of the instruments are considered for men, for masculine. But nowadays, lots of young generations of men are also playing the role of women.
Mm-hmm. Así que históricamente esta música, o sea, especialmente los juegos de campanas, eran para el dominio, digamos, de mujeres que tocaban esos instrumentos en particular. Pero ya se ha cambiado, se ha desarrollado, y hoy en día hay muchos hombres que también se han metido a tocar estos instrumentos. And here in California, what's happened here in California since you've brought the music here?
Well, most of the Filipinos born and raised in California and elsewhere in this country are the ones interested in learning this music. In the Philippines, it's different because Filipinos born and raised in the Philippines are more interested in learning Western music.
Entonces dice que aquí hay más interés que en las propias Islas Filipinas en aprender esta música, porque es algo muy especial aquí. Y dice que allá en las Islas Filipinas hay más interés en aprender música occidental, o sea, de aquí. Así que el interés aquí es aprender música de allá y el interés allá es aprender música de aquí. Así que el mundo está al revés. The world's in reverse there, backwards. So, but how have you seen this music grow here in California? ¿Cómo ha crecido esta música en California?
Well, lots of different Filipino performing groups. Every school, they have this Filipino cultural night, and they always use kulintang. They learn the dance from the Philippines, traditional dances, and they form their group. And most of the time they ask me to help them. So I go from place to place. We traveled with members of my group to disseminate, to perform this music. And so we also do workshop so that the younger generations of Filipinos and not Filipinos who are interested in learning this music will have the opportunity to hear and learn from us.
So, aquí sí ha habido mucho interés en la comunidad filipina más que nada, pero otra gente también en aprender la música. Así que le piden siempre a Dani Calanduyan que vaya con ellos para enseñar la tradición. Y ahora ellos están dando muchos talleres a jóvenes y es una algo una dimensión muy importante de su trabajo es trabajar con este con jóvenes. Titania Buchholz, what's your perspective on Kulintang music here in California?
Well, Kulintang music in California is something that I've been involved in probably 20 years or so. I first learned of Kulintang music as a child growing up in Alaska when I would hear it on the recordings of the music that people would dance the traditional Philippine folk dances to. When I was in Manila, I was able to study Kulintang music for a brief time, and then when I came back to the United States, there were no teachers, and it took a very long time. I think, well, for me a very long time, 17 years, before I settled in the Bay Area and I found a Kulintang teacher here who had studied under Danny. And after probably 4 or 5 years of studying with Danny's students, I graduated to work with Danny. And I have found that in California, whenever we do performances, people come up and they say, wow, this is amazing. This is from the Philippines. A lot of people who are born and raised in the United States have never seen this music. Actually, there's a lot of people in the Philippines who've never seen this music. And that's because this is an indigenous music. Under the Spanish regime and then under the Americans, it really wasn't performed much.
Así que Titania supo de esta música cuando estaba viviendo en Alaska. Y hay una comunidad de filipinos en Alaska también. Y cabe, vale la pena decir también que la comunidad filipina. It's worth mentioning, sort of at this point here, that the Filipino community is one of the largest Asian communities in the United States. Y creo que aquí en California es la comunidad asiática más, it's the largest Asian community in the state of California, right? Sí. And so there's enormous weight in terms of numbers and culture, as well as the quality and the exceptional quality of the level of performance of the music. So. How do you see this as being something California? We're trying to get a sense of there's music from the Philippines that's performed here, but then there's music that takes root here. So no, I don't know, cómo se ha arraigado aquí en California esta música para distinguir un poco de la música que ha venido de las Islas Filipinas y entonces que se ha tomado raíz aquí en California. How do you see this as being a California sound?
I can answer that because I think this is the only place in the world you're going to hear this kind of music. Even if you go back to the Philippines, it would be very difficult for you to hear this music with such an American accent. As one of the things about this music is that when you hear it in the Philippines, you can tell from the way it's played, you can hear an accent as to the location where the music is from. And the music that we play here has a California accent.
That's a beautiful metaphor. Estaba diciendo que esta música, como se toca aquí en California, tiene un acento, tiene su toque de California que lo hace un poco diferente. Es como hablar un idioma y hablar inglés y ser de Texas or the Vermont is like having a regional accent of language. So anyway, we're so appreciative of your regional accent that you've brought and created here in California. And so muchas gracias a ustedes. Muchas gracias por lo que han hecho y gracias por la presentación. Bueno, un placer.